SCI Center in Washington, D.C. And inside, a look at the Stanford Cardinal. Number 5 against number 2 Maryland. Stanford hasn't played in over a week since losing to North Carolina. Here's a look at their starting lineup. Sauer and Madsen, the Mad Dog up front, along with Tim Young struggling a bit. Weems and Lee in the backcourt for the 4-1 Stanford Cardinal. And there's a look at the head coach, Mike Montgomery, in his 13th season on the farm. And there's a look at the Maryland starting lineup. In the middle, it's Obina Ekezi, the senior, averaging a little over 11 points a game. Head coach Gary Williams in his 9th season at the helm in College Park.
I tell you, Gary's done an unbelievable job here since arriving. This is alma mater, has great enthusiasm. I see a sparkle in his eye. Look at this right here, Mark. I mean, we look at that record, 4-11. That's misleading. That took back many of those losses. That was in our producer's days, Kim Bell, when he played at Stanford. 1,600 rebounds in his career. He's going to be inducted in the Hall of Fame, our producer, Kimberly Dutton, in the truck.
All right. And we are underway. This is Stokes being guarded by Lee.
That is the part of the game that they have to show they can handle, Maryland, a half-court game.
Morris with the air ball. Maryland's leading scorer, sophomore,
really played well this year.
And this is where Maryland can hurt you.
Yeah, they really want to get it up and down. Stokes, they want to get it up and down. Experience. Terrell Stokes takes it to the goal from out of Simon Gratz High School in Philadelphia. He's got that bounce now. I saw a certain sparkle in Gary's eye. He is so really excited about this year's club, Mark.
He has good reason to be. Tons of talent on the floor.
They're already in trapping mode. Look at them right now. They can't wait to put the traps.
Bit of a delay. This is a look we'll see from Maryland during the course of the game. Three-court and full-court pressure.
Yeah, they change the areas they pick up at. Starting out here in a 2-1-2 pressure. Trying to lead it to the sideline.
And that's where they look to trap. From the baseline, Weems. And the Mad Dog hits to the stands.
He's an intense competitor. They got the open shot against the trap. They'll be well coached. Mike Montgomery does a solid job as a tactician. They got to make those open shots, because what happens when you miss, it just creates that fast-paced tempo that Maryland wants to play at.
Maryland averaging over 88 points a game coming into this one. And Steve Francis, the highly heralded and much touted junior college transfer, travels.
How's this for a track record? He was at Allegheny Junior College, didn't lose a game as the point guard last year. The year before, he was at San Jacinto Junior College in Texas, didn't lose a game during a regular season as the point guard. So he knows nothing but winning, winning, winning.
An unbelievable talent. Almost knocked away. And a foul called against number 3, LaRon Prophet.
See, the one thing that has to happen as you look at Francis right here, they got to take advantage of their interior people. Stanford, as you look at Steve Francis, an impact junior college jammer, very confident. He said, I don't think we're going to have much trouble with a lot of people, he said, because we got a deep team, a very talented team. I read one of those quotes from him in the papers.
Francis may be the best player in the country that people don't know about, but they will soon.
Oh, they'll know about him when he gets all that national exposure and visibility.
From the corner, Sauer, he can hit that. And he does.
Sauer could make that open shot, as you said. He's a versatile player. He's an experienced player. Dad, Mark Sauer, used to be the head guy with the Pittsburgh Pirates, now runs the Kiel Auditorium and runs the St. Louis Blues operations in hockey.
He's got clout on his side. Ekezi missing, rebound Stanford. Stanford, a very good rebounding team. Dick, they've out-rebounded all 5 of their opponents this year. Here's Lee. Got it. The second three-pointer of the game, and the Cardinal is out of the box quickly.
That is really a big plus for right now Stanford. Shooting the ball well early, making the game 5-on-5. See, so far, Maryland hasn't had any transition opportunities.
LaRon Prophet had broken out of his slump in Puerto Rico.
They got the MVP trophy. They were brilliant out there, blowing away Pittsburgh by like 25, 35. They blew them away.
And they were awesome.
Also beat a good UCLA team, but UCLA will be a different team now that they got Baron Davis back.
Stanford patient on offense here.
Trying to use the shot clock, look for the good shot.
Lee feeling it. Rebound Morris. Lee is playing with a bit of a hit pointer still, Dick.
He was sensational last year in the tournament. In 5 games, averaged better than 20 points a game. It was 35 for 35 on a free throw line in the NCAA.
And Steve Francis is rocking it.
That's big time. He wears number 23. Has another guy wore number 23 named Michael the Magnificent? I mean, he's got bounce to his game. He's got style. He's got all the pizzazz, Mr. Francis. There's that trap now pushed up to it.
Weems got it to fall. That's how they're going to make him pay.
Yeah, did a great job getting the ball into the high post area against the trap. And the experienced Weems, he's a kid that has to start to score. He's averaging 5 points a game. And last year made the all Pac-10 first team.
Yeah, he has taken the fewest field goal attempts out of all these Stanford starters. Traveling violation against Akizi.
See, Maryland early in this game doesn't like the rhythm that's being established. So much about basketball is tempo.
Right now, the Cardinal with a four-point lead just underway here in the first half. Stanford 3 of 5 from the field.
You don't go to the Final Four and return your top nine players and not be a pretty good, talented basketball team. I didn't think we saw the real backcourt of Stanford in the NIT.
They lost to North Carolina in the final there. Inside, Young missing.
Young operating down low. He's got to produce in here. He leads him in shot blocks.
One more look at Francis.
Jesse breaks you down. One-on-one, a little isolation, a little change of direction, floating in the air. He's got that good glide.
But against a lot of the NBA pros. Oh, what a feed. A easy foul, and Steve Francis is giving you a little bit of a show right now.
I say it's a little ooh and ah time with Steve Francis. It's high five time. He's going to have people really slapping a lot of high fives at the Cole Fieldhouse. Take a look at right now, Mr. Francis. A little shake and bake. A little shake and bake. Look, between the legs, around the back. I mean, it's all kinds of style. And he dishes. He says, come on, Abita, convert.
As they played the replay on the big screen here at the MCI Center, a lot of the fans were oohing and eyeing.
Abita was 9 for 9 on the foul line in his last game.
Akizi, one of the more improved players over the last 2 years.
Yeah, he's certainly made himself into an NBA first rounder. If you had a chart and rate the top five players in the East, I know my buddy Dickie Weiss, who does a great job as a national writer, writes for the Daily News as well. He said Akizi was one of the five best senior prospects, according to the NBA people, with Vontigo Cummings and Tim James, Trajan Langdon.
Maryland likes to press after a made free throw, which they do. Dick, so far you'd have to say that Stanford is handling the three-quarter court and full-court pressure well.
Well, you know, I'm not surprised, because the one thing you better have against a Maryland trap is have experienced guards. And with Lee and Weems, they've seen it all. Remember last year, they made that unbelievable march to the Final Four and lost a heartbreaker overtime game to Kentucky in the semis.
Lee with the ball.
These kids have been around. I mean, they're playing some big-time games. You got to post up to the ball. You got to step to the basketball against traps. Now it's a man-to-man, and now they go to execute. And they believe in execution. That's a strength of Mike Montgomery.
Here's Weems, good three-point shooter. Off the mark. Rebound, it'll be possession Stanford. Just underway here at the MCI Center, a battle of Stanford and Maryland. We come back.
I've known this guy 5 minutes. He's already giving me investment advice.
For a recommendation on your portfolio, please press 3.
I'm gonna pay for this.
What was I
thinking? Should my 401k be all stock?
Should my 401k be all cash?
Why didn't they write this last month?
My portfolio should be overweighted in game companies.
Why does this guy think what worked for him is gonna work for me?
Thank you, Payne Webber.
Murphy, I want you to pick my wife up from the airport. Her name is Thelma.
I'm Thelma.
Really?
Really.
Camry's extra value package with CD player and 6 speakers and a power driver's seat.
Thanks for the ride.
No problem, Mrs. Burns.
Who's Mrs. Burns?
Did we mention anti-lock brakes? The 1999 Camry. At least the road will be smooth. Special year-end savings on Camry. Available now.
Are you ready to make real noise? To make new friends? To take sharper pictures? Are you ready to build bridges? Learn diplomacy? Learn to swim? Are you ready to turn what you want to do into what you will do? Are you ready? Be all you can be.
When we drafted Tim Duncan, I invited him to my home to get ready for the season.
He was learning so much.
That doesn't count. You were out.
The roses are out, Timmy, not the daisies.
Till one day, you brought this into my home?
It's not something I'm proud of.
I calmly explained how Edge Pro Gel protects better than foam because it has 8 rich lubricants.
David, sure know how to make a guy feel comfortable.
More lemonade, Tim?
Edge Pro Gel. Save your skin.
The roses, Tim, are out of bounds.
Go with the gnomes. The gnomes can be out of bounds. No.
Washington, all that hot air from those politicians keeps things cooking. Hey, speaking of cooking, that running knot is one hot sports guy on News 7. I didn't write this.
Maryland trailing by 2. Just underway here in the first half. So far, Mark Lee's been involved with all 8 points. He hit the 3-pointer and he dished off for 2 assists. So King Arthur Lee, early in this game, has really established himself that he's going to be a vital part of some of the success that Stanford will have. As you look at Steve Francis, look at those numbers, played junior college for 2 years. You know, his senior year did not play in high school. His mom passed away, and his junior year he didn't play because of an injury.
As a permanent reminder of his mother, tattooed on his arm.
Man-to-man defense by Maryland in the half-court set. Got a lot of screening on the inside.
Sauer again from downtown.
Out of bounds, it'll be Cardinal ball. Some key players in this game can come right off that bench for Stanford. The 2 Collins kids certainly could be factors in this game because they're very, very strong and agile, but they're going to miss a key player in Ryan Mendez, one of the premier three-point shooters in America. Shot 47% from the three-point line last year. He's out with a knee injury.
Arthur Lee. Sauer couldn't get the tip to the goal, but there we see a demonstration of Stanford's offensive rebounding ability.
And they can really rebound offensively. I mean, they're like 2-1 against their opponents.
Entry pass inside.
Great ball movement. And a better block by the Mad Dog. You got to reward that to the defense. See, that's the extent of that rule now. The new rule, you wave off all to the possession there. On the block shot, the defense gets the ball. And that's really the way to... See, now watch the ball move. Morris going to throw the interior pass. They're going to bring it to the inside. And there's the Mad Dog. The Mad Dog with the jam. He's 1 of 10. Got a great family. His mom and dad, beautiful people.
He knows about sharing then, huh?
Gave me a Christmas card. He's got a brother at Columbia Medical School, sister at BYU. He's trying to post inside against Obina. A lot of contact.
Lee again. Can't find the mark.
Hey, one thing about Lee, he's not going to be bashful today. He's going to assert himself, and I think that's a positive.
Crawford has it knocked away, and here comes Stanford.
Great ball fake by Sal. Shooting a little too quickly for Mike Montgomery. I got to believe he's shooting the ball just a little too quickly.
Playing a Stanford, pardon me, a Maryland-type tempo right now.
So you don't want that pace up and down because, Mark, as you just said, that pace favors Maryland. They want this kind of pace. Make 3, 4, 5 passes, get screens. They do a great job screening vertically and also horizontally.
Kick it out. Stanford very patient on offense here.
Oh, what a great play.
And Sauer, great rebound.
That is execution. I didn't see that kind of execution in New York. Certainly got a credit with the defense that North Carolina put. Hey, what about North Carolina getting beat by John Kress? What a giant killer. College of Charleston.
Akizi inside. And he gets his first deuce of the ball game. Obina Akizi out of Nigeria. Played in the World Championships this past summer. One of the top rebounders in the tournament.
Great student as well. Going to get a degree in engineering. See, there's the trap. A little token pressure. Not really bothering Stanford. They're executing well. I mentioned North Carolina defensively played Stanford so tough, and Brendan Haywood played well on the interior, the 7-footer who's developing.
Sauer with a nice cut inside.
Bulldog. Nobody blocks out. We're going to have a good game here. We're going to have a good game because they're going to be able to handle the pressure. You can just see it and feel the tempo.
That question has been answered so far. 12-8. Stanford leading by 4. 13-10 to play in the first half. It's easy. Might have forced that Alton up a little bit.
Getting one shot. They got those trees inside, Stanford.
Lee. Young finishes.
Nice little two-man game. Young doesn't give you that spectacular ability, but he's the all-time shot blocker in the school history. He's also 4th in rebounding.
A lot of size inside for the guys from the farm.
They're really executing well. Now watch Mad Dog operate here, and then he dumps that little interior pass to his sidekick, to his running mate, Mr. Sauer. Now we're gonna watch again the little curl move. Now Mad Dog comes over from the weak side. Nobody checks out, and it's a jam.
Dick, all five Stanford players have scored so far, so they come out with a look of good balance.
Well, they look a lot better to me today than what they looked in New York. Now, I know it's early in this game, and Maryland's such an explosive team and a team that can really get out with their pressure and score in bunches. But right now, their guards look very comfortable handling Maryland's traps.
And right now, we have a substitution. Number 33 for Stanford, Jason Collins, coming into the ballgame, one of two twins. Jason, the other one being Jaron.
Yeah, JC, I'll tell you, two great students as well. In many programs, those guys are playing 30, 35 minutes a night. But everything is about winning at Stanford, and everything is about the team concept, and they understand that as they'll split time on the baseline.
Martisich, meanwhile, along with Miller in for Maryland, Francis down low on Lee.
I had Martisich in one of his games of his career against North Carolina when he stopped the Tar Heels on 118 in a row, and he played brilliantly off the bench.
Two incredibly deep ball clubs today. Martisich, not shy, coming off the bench. Sauer.
He said, get away, you know. Wow, he went after that rebound.
A contact inside, no whistle.
Good job of spacing and execution. Right now, you give the edge to Stanford the way they're executing their half-court game.
From a ranking standpoint, this is Maryland's toughest test of the early season.
Highest they've been rated since 1975 and 76, but they went 8 weeks with Lefty Driesell and company and were number two in America.
Collins down low.
John Lucas and Steve Shepard with four on the shot clock. Queens
with a three.
Where have you been, Mr. Weeds? I mean, this kid had 34 and 30 in games last year. He really went into a little slump in February, though, last year.
Juan Dixon from way downtown.
Dixon is a three-point shooter. He's a slasher as well. And they feel he's going to be a special player at Maryland.
A bit of a surprise. An upset brewing here at the NCI Center. 11:38 to play in the first half.
So, what'll it take for you to buy this car today?
You're buying this SUV today or not?
I want you to drive out
of here. I want you to walk out of here with
just for you. I got
to tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to talk to my boss.
My supervisor.
Hey, we're going to have a deal, right?
Log on to AutoBuyTel.com. Arm yourself with dealer invoice and retail list prices. Choose any make, any model. No hassles, no haggling, low prices. AutoBuyTel.com. We're changing the way America buys cars.
At Pep Boys, get four of our 35,000-mile tires at a low $99. Or double your mileage with four 70,000-mile, all-season steel-belted tires, just $169.
Pep Boys.
Cars like us.
People love us.
Insuring over 40 million people worldwide.
My mom's a bank person.
Fire me.
My dad has this real important job with this big fancy office where he's the boss. He always eats lunch at these big fancy restaurants. And after he's done saving the world, we go home and play. I'd give him a 10. I drew a picture of you.
The 1999 Camry. Even heroes need a car. Special year-end savings on Camry. Available now.
John Daly and Laura Davies, golf's longest hitters, combined forces in the JCPenney Classic. Today at 4 Eastern on ABC.
Bit of a surprise brewing so far. A shorthanded Stanford team leading by 9 with 11:38 to play in the first half. And all your college football questions will be answered. Coming up next on ABC, it's the Bowl Championship Series Selection Show. John Saunders and Todd Blackledge in the studio. And who's it going to be? Ohio State? Florida State matched up with Tennessee. We will find out. Dick, what do you think?
Oh, I think there's no question. It's Florida State's going to hook up with Tennessee. I think the big interesting thing will be the Sugar Bowl. I think the Sugar Bowl is going to end up taking Florida, and I think they'll have two picks. As you see, breaking the trap right here, kicking it out.
Nice little selection right there.
What a tremendous job by the guards. Doing an excellent job in that scenario. I think you'll see in that Sugar Bowl, Florida, Texas A&M, and Syracuse will play in the Orange Bowl. I think Ohio State's going to get selected to play Florida in the Sugar Bowl.
Find out coming up next.
Oh, nice little Terrence Horn
with a little jump hook to break the ice. 19 to 10, and Maryland trailing by 9.
There comes the trap now. Remember, you got to score to be able to establish your traps. Maryland's only had 8 points coming up to the first 8 minutes. They had 32 in the game against Wake Forest when they were up at one time.
Yeah, they made the
big number.
Pardon me, Dick. They made their first 14 shots.
Unbelievable. They were up at one time, I believe, 54-29 in that game, and they really put the unbelievable. They stopped Robert O'Kelly, an outstanding guard, a super south for Wake Forest. Shut him down big time.
On offense, Maryland has turned it over 5 times. There's a look at the other half of the twin connection. Yeah, Jaren saw it.
Jason's the one that had the knee injury, sat out last year, and Jaren, as Francis, he wants a foul. He kisses it off the glass. He's a kid that likes to get into the 3-second area and uses great legs, that great vertical jump.
They break the pressure, wings. Couldn't finish.
Now, this is what they want. They want you to miss, and here they come. We haven't seen this all game, but that's what they want, baby.
Let the track meet begin.
Oh, they call a walk. Wave it off. Wave it off.
Francis with a little palming violation. Obviously, a carry. Lee in the backcourt. Maryland still trying to trap. Now they call the play. Good patience still by Stanford.
They've done a great job attacking the pressure.
Collins fouled inside by Martisich. And Gary Williams is hot on the sideline.
Well, when is he not hot? Now he is always hot. I know him back in the days at Camden, but he coached at Woodrow Wilson High School and won a state championship and went undefeated. And he hasn't changed one bit. He has such a passion and love for what he's doing. He enjoys it. He absolutely feels it. It's all his entire life is coaching on that sideline. He just got a 7-year extension.
Nice ticket.
I asked him for a raise today, and he didn't give me any money. I said, loan me some cash.
Because you hit him up after I did. Williams has really returned this Maryland program back to national prominence.
Very proud today, telling John Feinstein, who's one of the organizers of this game, and myself back there, that he's really proud. His daughter just got her master's degree. She's teaching.
Meanwhile, Collins at the line as Akizi checks in for Maryland. Martisich will sit back down on the bench.
You know, Akizi in the East, when you thought the best senior centers, you'd have to also put in there Larry Kettner from Massachusetts, who got beat last night by Marshall, and they have a big date at home where they can really create some problems against Connecticut Wednesday night on ESPN.
And there's a look at more Stanford offensive rebounding. They lead by 8. Joe Bikini in the game now.
Joe Bikini, a good ball handler from out of Utah, was recruited by Rick Majerus.
Not shy, may have blocked.
His dad played for George Raveling at Washington State. His uncle played at Stanford. Yeah, his uncle played at Stanford. I love that name, Joe Bikini. We got a Scalapini that plays for Southern Cal, and a Joe Bikini. He said those Paisans can't play hoops.
Akizi.
I'll tell you one thing. There'll be no intimidation. No intimidation with the kids of Stanford. They believe they can win. They can play against anyone. But look at Akizi. He's going to catch it inside. They're going to try to double him up. There's the rotation. There's Mr. Collins.
He was seeing double, I guess, huh? A couple times.
Yeah, I'm seeing double right now.
9:35 to play in the half.
Playing Martisich and Akizi together.
And Danny Miller. Miller gets it back.
Outstanding high school player in New Jersey last year. Gary's very excited about their depth.
And it's Stanford ball. And now the call will be reversed. and it will be awarded to the Terrapins. Ted Hillary, Tim Higgins, and Tom O'Neill are officiating crew today.
See, the players right now got to just concentrate and not worry about blowing a whistle. They got to absolutely just concentrate, the Maryland kids, because they're going to be in for a war here today when you see this kind of bounce and the effort out of the Stanford gang.
I don't think they've been down this late in the ball game in their eighth contest so far this year. Martisic lost the handle.
They've been blowing people out. I mean, they've just been blowing out good teams as well. I mean, it was no contest with UCLA. And then after Pittsburgh beat Kentucky, they put the hurt on Pittsburgh big time against Montego Cummings and Ralph Willard's club, who's surprised by beating Xavier at Kentucky.
Phil Zucchini gets it over midcourt.
In fact, Proffitt got the MVP, and he has not been a factor here at all, LaRon Proffitt.
Proffitt on the bench sitting beside the coaching staff right now. Sauer with the floater. Stanford banging the offensive glass. Collins. Collins again.
I'll tell you, they get off on the offensive boards. They really work the glass.
There's that half-court Stanford offense.
See, they're going to make them play 5-on-5.
Miller.
That helps you. The guys can shoot the three from the wing, and that's what they expect out of Danny Miller off the bench.
Miller with his first 3 points of the ball game. The lead down to 5, and that gets a rise out of the Maryland supporter.
And there's that trap again. They got to show patience and poise against the trap.
Arthur Lee getting set to come back into the game. The steadying influence as Stanford calls a timeout.
Joe Bacini's going to be really tested here against the quickness of Maryland.
Maryland in the midst of a 7-1 run, Dick.
Yeah, they're that kind of team. Look at here, a score, unbelievable, 88 a game, only allowing 52, a plus 35 margin. Closest game was by 16, and that was even more. I mean, they were dominating that game, but Steve Lavin played that game without Baron Davis, and they need the big guy back. He's an outstanding point guard.
And on the glass, Stanford has really been getting it done.
There's Stanford working on the glass. They come in with a 2-1 ratio on the offensive boards against their opposition. I said that Pac-10 should be interesting. I still think Arizona is going to get better and better as you watch Miller shoot the trifecta, coming off the bench, giving him a big three, and also UCLA. UCLA's got so much young talent.
And there's another turnover. Maryland with those active hands defensively. In the midst of a 7-1 run. Marzec working hard to post up. It's Miller.
Hello, Miller time! Oh, it's Miller time!
Hits another three-pointer.
Danny Boy, oh, Danny Boy, comes in and knocks down two big threes.
And he gets nailed for the foul, reaching over the top.
Mosley playing now. He's a three-point shooter. There's the former Maryland captain, played here, has a great love for the university.
Stanford lead down to 2, courtesy of a couple of threes by Danny Miller. We'll be right back.
Okay, it's my big debut. Here we go. Wise. Okay, I'm ready when you are.
Good.
Wise.
Did he forget his line or what? Is this the regular one or is he the understudy? Is this? Yeah, thank you. Yeah, hey, you gotta wait for me. Let's hold it, not you. He goes, then I... Wait a second, not you. Hold it, Wise. Why? I can't work in this environment. Cut! Cut!
What you don't get with cut-rate car insurance is a State Farm agent to turn to when you need help.
I'm lonely.
So if you get into an accident,
Mr. Lonely,
you could end up feeling,
wish I had someone,
very much alone.
To call on.
Don't want to feel all alone? Go with the good neighbor service you get with a State Farm agent.
Mom, look at that. That is the one I want.
Sweetie,
everybody's got
one. We can't
one.
Get that now.
Come on.
Honey, what did
check
I say?
Check this out.
No.
I haven't gotten a toy in long. Come on.
No.
I have to get that.
Little kids get what they want.
Sweetie.
Shouldn't you?
Okay.
Yes.
Introducing Solara. An entirely different kind of Camry. It's for you.
Yeah.
It is more than a trial by fire. It is a rite of passage. And if you can master your fear, outsmart your enemy, and never yield, even to yourself, you will be changed forever. The few, the proud, the Marines.
ADC Tonight. The holidays bring out the best in everyone.
Are we a couple?
I could fall in love with you all over again if I let myself.
An all-new practice ABC Tonight.
20-18, the lead cut down to a tenuous 2 points. Courtesy of a couple of Danny Miller three-pointers. Dick, your early impressions of this game. Thank you.
Well, I'm really impressed with you. Too. Stylish. I mean, you want some love dressed like that. I mean, this guy's too good-looking to work with. I'll tell you this. The early impressions were, as soon as they went to the bench, Stanford really ran into trouble. It got a little chaotic out there, and that's what Maryland wants. When Stanford played their experienced starting five, Stanford really took command of the game. Hey, this is a trivia question for you. Wow. I don't know this answer.
I can't believe we may have stumped you. We're not sure yet.
Stumped me big time on that.
Who are the four players in NCAA history with over 2,000 points and 1,000 rebounds and a 60% field goal percentage? That is our Aflac trivia question. We'll give you the answer in just a few moments.
Well, one's got to be Jerry Lucas. One's got to be Jerry Lucas, former Ohio State Buckeye.
Arthur Lee back in the ballgame for Stanford. This is Mosley, who has good range.
Well, he shot 43% from the three-point line last year.
Stanford sometimes gives you all three-point shooting or it's all inside. And Gary Williams, very much aware of that yesterday when I was talking with him in practice, said that they've got to guard that three-point shot. There's not much of that intermediate game that Stanford gives you, not so far in the season anyway.
Well, you know, perimeter defense against the three is so important. Today, if you don't lock up the three-point line, that just changes the whole complexion of a game so quickly. But Stanford has the guys that can make that three, and Mosley certainly one of them.
Collins, Jason Collins with the foul on Abina Akizi. 7:07 to play in the first half. Maryland down by four.
Jason Collins, that's his second personal.
And don't forget that tonight on our cable cousin ESPN, it's primetime NFL football. Chicago against Minnesota, live at 8:15 Eastern time. Randy Moss is setting the league on fire, as is Stevie Francis. Then Monday night on ABC, get a look at the Green Bay Packers on ABC Sports, NFC Central battle between the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and the Green Bay Packers.
Well, I'll tell you one thing right now. Tampa Bay is walking out with that W at Raymond James Stadium, so tell Brett Favre and company to stay in the locker room. They have no shot against my guy Sapp and company. Tony Dungy's team is going to make an unbelievable run at the end of the year.
They need to. Here's Mosley missing.
Stevie Francis has such unbelievable leaping ability. He made a great drive down the lane before using that athletic ability.
Francis with 6 points in the ball game. The foul is on Jaron Collins.
One of the keys early in the game has been the fact that Prophet, Morris, and Francis each only had one shot for a period of time in terms of attempts at the goal. They're going to start to assert themselves a little bit more offensively.
Maryland, Dick, with an opportunity to tie. Miller's been taking over. Missing that time. Rebound, Weems.
Miller shows good inside-outside ability. He's going to be a good player down at Maryland.
He's got a great bounce.
Maryland does a great job getting back quickly.
Lee being guarded by Francis.
Yeah, one of the great finishes I've ever seen in a game in the NCAA tournament against Rhode Island. 13 points in the last 2 minutes and put an unbelievable show to stop him from a 6-point deficit with 59 seconds, as you see Lee come up big there.
Lee hitting a baseline jump shot gives him 7 points for the ball game.
King Arthur's playing today. He didn't play like that in New York.
He's injured against St. John's. Akizi fouled by Young. He'll get two at the stripe. That's two fouls on Young.
You know, Akizi went through a four-game period this year where the most he scored was 8 points. As you watch right now, Lee against Francis. A little one-on-one maneuver here. Now he's going to pull up, shoot the J. There it is. He can shoot that jump shot. He averaged 20 a game for a five-game period in the NCAA tournament. Having a little conversation with Mr. Stokes and where we're going out for dinner tonight.
Hey, Arthur Lee is from South Central Los Angeles, so he knows no fear.
Talk about South Central. What a great story when you think about it for Utah with Miller. Andre Miller had a big game last night and a win on the road against Long Beach State. Look at Billy Hahn, fine assistant coach. Coaching here, filled in for Gary Williams. when Gary had a problem physically 2 years ago. Easy. Second one on the way. Seton getting set to check in for Stanford. Love to see kids develop like Ozino and Cheesy. He didn't come in with a big-time reputation, but with hard work, really kept making himself better and better. Maryland's got a good recruit coming in from New Jersey next year at 6'8", and Taj Holden, they're really happy about. And a young man, a point guard from Oak Hill Academy, come out of Miami, Steve Blake. And Stanford got a great one in Casey Jacobson out of Glendora, California.
Blake led at Miami High. Stanford leading by two.
Stanford really executing a half-court game. A lot of ball movement right there. Good job by Morris.
Morris, first time.
Oh, showtime. Skywalker up, up, and away. He's a high riser, Terrence Morris.
We are tied at 24 apiece.
It's a great story. Patience, patience, patience. Terrence Morris did come in and get a lot of minutes right out of the gate. See, this is what they want to create.
Weems and Madsen couldn't hang on. So Stanford a little frazzled right now at the edges. Lee almost lost it, and then Madsen did.
I'll tell you, they're a little frazzled, you're right, right now. They need to stop Stanford, take away some momentum. Oh, if he can make that shot, he's got the whole package. If he can make the perimeter J, baby, he's explosive. He can get to the rack. Well, they're going to love him down at Cold Fieldhouse. Steve Francis is going to be electricity.
He is a perfect 4-for-4 from the field. And they are bringing the noise right now.
They're going to make some extra passes here, Stanford.
Weems. Seton puts a silencer on the crowd. They needed that one.
That's a big basket by Seton. A veteran player, not getting a lot of minutes right now.
Maryland's lead, 1 point. We approach 4 minutes to play in the half. This is number two against number five, and Francis is feeling it. Madsen takes him down to the court.
See, Lee's got to back it out now. He's got to back it out. Shooting too quickly. That's too quickly right now. That's what Maryland wants.
It's out of bounds. And it is off Maryland. It'll be Stanford ball when we come back. And Terrence Morris brought a little Sunday surprise for us. We'll be right back to the MCI Center right after this.
Dad wouldn't have called this retirement. I mean, who would have
thought? When did I get to retire from managing my money? Now that I have
trustees.
Seven grandkids.
Kind of funny how investing was easier when I didn't have any money.
Titanium bikes are overrated.
I just always thought earning money was the hard part. Keeping it's the real job.
I wonder, should we take the income?
Should we reinvest?
Thank you, Payne Weber.
Holidays.
Celebrate.
I believe I've missed each and every face. Come on and play one easy. Let's turn on every love light in the place. It's time I found myself totally surrounded in your circles. Oh, my.
There's one time of the year when everyone should be in good hands.
Celebrate. Marty's here.
Let's see a fuel injector for a Ford Probe. A starter for a Saab.
EGR valve for a 74 Gremlin.
See you tomorrow, Marty.
Pep Boys.
Cars like us.
People love us.
Hey,
Payne Weber College Basketball on ABC and Raycom Sports brought to you by the Toyota Solara Coupe, an entirely different kind of Camry. It's for you. Edge Pro Gel, lose the foam, save your skin. United States Marine Corps, the change is forever. And by Budweiser, now is the perfect time to enjoy a fresh, cold, Beechwood-aged Budweiser. Maryland leading by one with 3:58 to play. Get back to our Aflac trivia question. We asked you, who are the four players in NCAA history with over 2,000 points, 1,000 boards, and a 60% field goal percentage? The answer.
Oh, wow. Look at this here. Adam Kiefenier from Stanford. Wow. David Robbins had such a great career. Ewing and Alcindor. Alcindor, the greatest center ever to play college basketball.
Here's Maryland with the steal off the inbound pass. Francis, and he's fouled.
He's got such a spark to his game. Flash, pizzazz, really gets up and down in transition. Look at the field goal percentage right now. Teams are shooting 31. Look at his steals, 15.9 a game. Wow.
They make the artful dodger look like an amateur.
Well, you know, I like that line. But I'll tell you this, you know, Mark, sometimes statistics this early in the year really are meaningless. But you got to remember, they played some quality teams up in Puerto Rico. It hasn't just been Cupcake City.
A victory over UCLA in that Puerto Rico tournament. Meanwhile, Francis at the line, a 72% free throw shooter, makes both to give the Terps a three-point lead. He has 11 points in the game. And that gives them an opportunity to put the press on.
Now they go full court. They go full court. They want to go full throttle. They just want to run. They want to R&R. They want to rip and run.
Mosley, way off. Seaton had the rebound and was fouled inside by Juan Dixon.
Yeah, Mosley hesitated on that shot. He was not sure whether or not he should kiss it on a glass or not and knock it down. You know, you think about Stanford. Their athletic director has to be so proud, Ted Leland, when you think about the fact 4 years in a row they've been the winners of the Sears Cup, emblematic of having the best all-around sports programs in America. That is amazing. 4 years in a row.
Women's basketball, perennial champions.
Well, Bob Vesquez does a great job as their SID, and they were telling me a story out of New York that if you took all the Olympic athletes when they were playing during the last Olympics, that Stanford, with all the points that they gathered, Stanford athletes, they would have finished like 12th in the world. That's amazing.
With Lee way off the mark. Proffitt with the lob.
Nice look by Proffitt. Throws that diagonal pass to Terrence Morris. Are they quick? I'll tell you one thing. They have such superb quickness, Maryland. A great transition team. They are going to really put the hurt on a lot of clubs.
The tide of this game has changed big time in the last 5 minutes.
Yeah, when Stanford went to their bench, they really got out of their rhythm and were not able to execute like they did earlier in the game. But he certainly has to go and take advantage of his experienced people on the bench. They got to produce.
The 3-on-2. Proffitt had it knocked away. Francis!
Oh, you gotta like that. What athletic ability. What unbelievable. We talk about athletic ability. We talk about quickness, jumping ability. Here goes Proffitt. He's gonna lay one up, and he said, we got a Proffitt, baby. This Mr. Morris is worth the Proffitt. And now we're gonna see Proffitt right here lose the ball. Francis picks it up. Look, you can't teach that hang time. You can't teach that hang time.
He has 13 points in the ball game. Make that 14. And Maryland now leads by 8 points. They have 11 fast break points of the game.
Well, we talked about it, Mark. They're such an explosive spurt team.
Don't forget, coming up at halftime, it's the autobuysell.com halftime report. Scores and highlights for you.
Roberts. They will drive you bananas with that trapping defense. I'll tell you, get Robin Roberts out here. She'll handle that trap. She was a big-time player when she played on the college level.
Got a little bit of game herself.
He's got game.
McKeezy posting up inside. And is fouled by Collins.
I'll tell you why Maryland is so good. They can hurt you in so many parts of the floor. They can hurt you on the perimeter. Look at the fast break transition game. That's where they excel. They can hurt you in the 3-second area with Akizi. They can hurt you on the wings with guys like Morris and Proffitt. And they can hurt you on the perimeter with a guy like Francis.
And they are deep, too, as we look at their bench. Gary Williams has used 8 different players already today.
I think you're going to see a change in the complexion of the ACC this year. In the past, it's been such a balanced league. I think this year there's going to be such dominance up on top. I think when you look on top and you think Maryland and Duke, and certainly North Carolina is going to be thrown in that mix when they get a guy like Ron Curry into a basketball mode, and they also get Vasco Eftimov to give him another player off the bench. I think those three teams are going to separate themselves from the rest of the pack. Clemson could create problems. Riley Shiat's club in the middle with a great guard I love in McIntyre, Terrell McIntyre.
Stokes, another Terrell guarding Lee, and they turn it over, but there's a foul on Miller, who came on the run and jump, the double team.
Well, you know, you mentioned the run and jump. You cannot turn your back and try to spin dribble against Maryland. Look at Gary. He's got that look of confidence. He's trying to be a professor on the sideline. Very calm right now. Of course, look at this here. Seven turnovers on this run.
A 28-7 devastating run. 2.5 minutes to play in the half. Lee at the line for Stanford.
This is at the MCI Arena. Back home at the Cole Fieldhouse, that building just rocks like you can't believe. One of the great environments. They're going to really do showtime there.
And they're talking about getting a new building now at Maryland. Not sure I want to do that. His team, Gary Williams' team, has a great home court advantage there.
Well, they should get a new building, though, because Gary should start it off by making a nice donation from that big, big salary increase he got.
Lee makes two. Cuts the lead from down to 36-28.
Next 2.5 minutes, very big for Stanford. They got to go on a little spurt here to get a little momentum going into that locker room. They can't let Maryland jump to double-figure lead.
Morris with the baseline move.
There's the wing. Talking about Terrence Morris. What an improved player this guy is from last year. He was a diaper dandy with a lot of potential marks last year, but now he's really developing.
A frenetic-looking Gary Williams on the sideline. You'd never know that his team was up 11 points.
He's that way when they're up 30.
Madsen out top. Down to 10 on the shot clock. Weems had it knocked away, and they're going to stay Cardinal ball.
See, the one thing we were talking about before we got on the air, you, myself, and certainly Kim Dalton, our producer, about the fact that Stanford now is, right now, no longer the team that's putting on people. Everybody knows about their reputation in that Final Four, and they got to really come to play every night.
Madsen coming in.
He comes to play. I'll tell you one thing, the Mad Dog comes to play. There is no doubt about it. He gives you every ounce of energy he has.
And they get it under 10 points. With 1:30 to play in the first half, they trail by 9. McKeezy wheeling on Collins, and he's called for the hook.
Tommy Nunez with the call, once worked in the
Maryland
NBA.
Number 54, Alvina McKeezy. That's his first personal eighth team foul.
His first personal foul, eighth team foul. Stanford now with a chance to cut it down to 7.
Psychologically, the reputation gets out, and that reputation about their trap and their pressure really affects people. Then affect them there. That's a good possession right there when Lee's scoring.
Yeah,
Weems scoring there on the inside.
Down to 7. Maryland up by 7. LaRon Prophet still scoreless in the ballgame. Vic Francis is having a good first half, though. Here comes Stanford again, under a minute to play in the half.
Big stop. Big stop right there.
Lee may be pressing a little bit that time. Stokes. Prophet. Still scoreless.
You got to protect this basketball. This is a big possession. You want to get a score here. Get a little momentum.
Who would have ever thought Maryland would lead by 7 with their one of their best players, Prophet, scoreless?
He's their MVP. That's why they're such a dangerous team, though. They have so many different weapons.
Partially blocked on that one. Prophet came up with a defensive play.
They're going to run it for the last shot. Stokes out of Simon Grass would have produced also in Philadelphia. Rasheed Wallace. What an explosive team, people. We're seeing, I think, right now, unless someone shows me differently, this is the best team in America the way they play.
Stokes kicks it out to Akeezy. Not the guy you want taking the last shot from out there anyway.
I think there's a separation right now in America when you talk about dominant teams with Connecticut, Maryland, and Duke.
Gary Williams' crew with a 7-point lead at halftime. Prophet still scoreless. Let's go back to Robin Roberts in our studio.
All right, Mark and Dickie V, thank you very much. Coming up on the Autobuy.
The score at halftime, the Maryland Terrapins lead by 7 over the Stanford Cardinal here in one of the biggest interconference battles of this early college basketball season. Welcome back, everyone. I'm Mark Jones along with Dick Vitale. Dick, I said at the top of the show, pressure makes diamonds or pressure busts pipes. Right now, Maryland looking like 14-karat gold.
Well, they really are, and especially the second 10 minutes, they played exceptionally well. Early in the game, the tempo was really being controlled by the guards of Stanford, and they executed well. They went to their bench, didn't get the kind of productivity in terms of producing in a half-court game, and it really created a problem. You look right now, it's amazing when you see that quickness, the superb quickness that Maryland possesses. They are so explosive. They went on that spurt, and it just got themselves that lead where they walked in. But remember this, this is anybody's game yet.
Steve Francis had a big half. He scored 14 points for Maryland, the top scorer in the game so far, getting into the lane and working his magic.
Yeah, he really does a great job getting into that lane. He also showed he can shoot the downtown trifecta. He's so explosive, he's gonna be an outstanding player as he gets more and more experience. Remember, he's gonna make some trips around the conference, but there's no doubt about it that this guy is the real deal. He's a real gem. There's no doubt about it.
And in the first half, Maryland rebounded to get that tempo back, like you said, and shot 50% compared to Stanford's 37.
I thought it was big in that half. Stanford, when you looked at their production from the three-point line, 3 for 14, they hit their first two, but as our fine with the wealth of knowledge he possesses, Marty Arnoff, our stat guy, told us they missed 11 out of their last 12.
Stanford with possession to begin the second half of play. Stanford against number 2 Maryland.
They got to establish a rhythm now to their half-court offensive game right here and get the kind of shots they did earlier in the game. Good execution, get it inside.
Young had a slow first half and misses much in the same way here in the second.
And the big guy's got to produce in that lane. I mean, you're talking about a guy that's got a world of experience. He lost a year, was a redshirt actually because he had a problem with his back. But he's got tremendous numbers in terms of looking at his career numbers at Stanford.
He is just 1 for 3 from the field. 2 points in the game. Arthur Lee playing with that hip pointer. Still not quite 100% yet, but good enough so far today.
Well, that happened in the Garden when he made that comeback against that quick St. John's team, who I think is going to be really one of the real teams to really be concerned about in the Big East. But he banged into Ron Artis, knocked him out of bounds, and then he strolled down the other end, and he knocked down 2 big free throws to win that game after being down by 10 late in the game.
There's Lee out top.
Yeah, 35 in a row in the NCAA tournament.
Inside with a nice jump hook.
See, that's patience and that's execution. And they have to have that. They got to have patience, patience, patience. And that usually presents points. PPP. PPP.
Lead down to 5. Profit still scoreless. That one partially blocked. There's Lee. Batted away at the last minute by Akizi.
See, I don't think you want to force that action. I think you got to back it out.
Morris couldn't find the handle.
So you don't have numbers now. You got to back it out. He's got to bring it out.
Lee.
Where are you going here? That's absolutely, that's a bad shot right there by an experienced player. He's too good, Mr. Lee.
Francis elevated and almost got the left-handed layup to go.
What happens there, Mark? You open up the whole floor, and that's what Maryland wants you to do. They want to open up the entire floor. Mike Montgomery cannot be happy with the shot selection of Lee, right? We see this is what they should be doing. Executing, take advantage of the big strength inside of Arnold Schwarzenegger. I didn't know he could play basketball, Schwarzenegger. As I look at Mike Montgomery, 4 years in a row for the NCAAs, certainly not happy at all with that last possession.
Meanwhile, Francis.
And they made 18 in a row over the last 2 games on a free throw line. Look at the coaching of Mike Montgomery, a real professor who loves to teach, loves to get in that gym. He's the perfect coach for Stanford. He fits them perfectly.
Yeah, Dick, he was telling me that yesterday they didn't want to come out and play a soft schedule because everyone would be gunning for them early in the year. He wanted his troops to get used to a high level of competition. Coming off of that Final Four appearance, the foul whistled against Stokes.
I think really when you look at Stanford's situation with all that experience, they want to play against the better people to get a real evaluation. Now look, watch the defense. See, Stokes does a great job. Now watch him reach from around. See, he likes to come from around the backside, trying to deflect that basketball.
And Stokes will have the room service layup off the steal.
That's where they excel. They excel in transition. They convert so well after turnovers.
7th steal of the ball game for Maryland. They are turning up the pressure meter on Stanford. Bring the ball back out, back it out. Slow it down, slow that pace down. Take advantage of your strength on the interior. Foul on Akizi. Tried to knock it away from Young, and Mike Montgomery is working his team from the sidelines big time.
Well, they're going to get a lot of help when they get back Mendez, and also Michael McDonald. He's out with an ankle problem, who's really a solid backup point guard.
That's putting a lot more minutes on the shoulders of Arthur Lee.
Look at those cards. They're flashing all kinds of series that they like to run offensively. Coach Taylor came from Montana. He's the head coach and now sitting on the staff as an assistant here.
Coming up number two. We'll see if two leads to two. Weems for three. Rebound Maryland. Stokes.
Here they go. They want to run, baby. They want to run, run, run.
Morris claimed he was fouled. That's not showing a little patience.
See, that's playing with a good basketball IQ. That's what you have to play.
Weems wide open for three. Madsen with the putback.
Madsen working on the glass. Weems comes up empty again from that trifecta.
Madsen, a guy that beefed up over the summer, lost a lot of his baby fat. This year, coming in as an All-America candidate, he has 8 points along with five rebounds.
Hasn't had a lot of touches on the inside either.
No. Went to him early on the first possession of the half and got an easy one. Here's Francis. Fowler with the rebound for Stanford. The Cardinal can cut the lead down to five.
Take advantage of Madsen. Go inside to Madsen. Go inside to the big guy.
He must have heard you, Dick, by now because the lead is down to five. And
gotta
here comes the Cardinal.
Got to go inside to that big guy until somebody proves they can handle him on the inside, Mark. Take advantage of that stretch.
That's their first fast break points, two of the ball game. Madsen beginning to enforce himself. Profit. Still can't find the mark.
There's Madsen cleaning the glass. Gotta back it out. Gotta execute.
They hold up number 43 from the bench. Williams looking a little bit more anxious now on the sideline.
They're so structured. They call those series, but now they want to dump it inside. See? Little screen down, dump it inside.
Young got a good look.
What a great offensive rebound by Madsen. The mantle really taking over on that baseline. Look at the emotion. Plays with feeling.
He's out of the doghouse and starting to bark.
I like that, Mark. Where do you come up with all of these? You must sit up night thinking about them. Oh, wow.
I've been hanging around you. One more look.
Watch Mad Dog from the weak side. A lot of rebounds come to that side after you miss on the right. And there he is with the reverse layup. Look at the emotion. Look at this guy. Look at this guy. Does he want to win? Does he want to play? Look at those pins. I'm telling you, those guns are unreal, but they can't match our producers.
Referring to Kimberly Belton. And we have a whistle.
Kimberly second in all-time rebounding at the university. Also one of its top scorers in the Hall of Fame. Wow.
Madsen will get a well-deserved rest, sitting now with 12 points and 7 boards. He scored their last 8 points.
It's going to be interesting to see now. Remember, they went to the bench last time in that first half, and it really created a problem.
Francis missing, Akizi missing the putback.
Power hustle
on the floor and making a great play.
Great hustle. They got Sauer, they missed it. Bring it back out, slow it down.
Lee fouled by Stokes.
Gary Williams said this is going to be a real test for us because we have not been tested in a half-court situation, and we know today we're going to meet that test. And they've done some good things in a half-court sets, Williams' club.
They led by 7 at half. It's down to 3.
Fans, it's now time for
I think the market's going to go up 20% next year.
What are
the
tickets, folks? I'm out.
I keep reading about tax-efficient investing. Should I be doing that?
Everybody else seems to.
Let's see. Rates are falling. Inflation's low. More stocks are more fun.
Hey. Oh, man.
Look at this. Investment strategies for you. Great. Just for me. And 5 million other people.
Thank you, Payne Weber.
Introducing the Nissan Frontier V6. With shift-on-the-fly four-wheel drive and 200 foot-pounds of torque, it's the perfect truck for those really, big jobs. The Nissan Frontier.
My definition of a good neighbor is someone who's there, ready and willing to help you at your time of need. That's why State Farm is proud to work with many organizations like Neighborhood Housing Services. I think State Farm supports organizations like NHS because they help an old neighborhood become new again and alive again. And I see people that are certainly, they take pride in ownership of where they live. I've seen the results, and I've seen what can happen in a community with the combined efforts of NHS and State Farm.
Say, hey, that's a foul in Japanese. Do you know where in the heavens to find a human voice? Where in your soul to find character?
One, two, three,
do you know the shortest distance to a college degree is a straight line called discipline? Do you know how to walk it? Be all you can be.
Weber College Basketball on ABC and Raycom Sports, brought to you by Payne Weber. Thank you, Payne Weber, for the advice. Aflac, insuring over 40 million people worldwide. Nissan, who reminds you that life is a journey. Enjoy the ride. AutoBuyTel.com. We're changing the way America buys cars. Welcome back to the MCI Center in Washington, D.C. I'm Mark Jones, joined by Dick Vitale. Number two, Maryland leads number five, Stanford, by three. But look at this. Madsen has actually taken charge here in the second half.
Gage really done a great job in the low blocks on the interior. Has really punished Maryland down here. They like seeing him sitting on that sideline. They want him to be an assistant coach. His physical presence has really been a valuable part of the half-court offense.
Maryland is one of seven from the field in this half. Here's Lee. Stokes closely guarding him.
Lee trying to run that offense against the good defensive ability of Stokes.
Weems had a notion and finally fires. Collins batted it away, but he fouled Martisic.
Yeah, Collins over the back of Martisic. That's three on him.
Denver is a lot of big people. They can use up a lot of fouls.
Well, they got a lot of guys they can rotate in. They really have a lot of size up front and a lot of experienced players.
There's Stokes, guarded by Lee.
Lost that tough overtime game.
There's the lock to Francis.
He's a high riser. He's the elevator man. He's got explosive bounce to his game.
That's the play they love to run for him.
Get a diagonal back screen. And there comes the trap. I got to watch that creating momentum. See, this is a big possession. You got to neutralize that jam. Slow it down. Don't let him get into gear.
Young back inside.
He's got to hit one. He has not been able to hit one down in the box.
His third consecutive miss. He is one for four from the field.
They need your big fella who experienced to really contribute inside. They're going to need Matt going on that floor quickly.
Yeah, I was just going to ask you how long you leave him on the bench for. Stokes patiently inside to Akizi. Francis with control out to Stokes.
See, I think if Matt goes on the floor in that possession, they don't come up with that second shot.
Good point.
But you got to give him a little rest. You got people you believe in. He's got people on that bench. He really feels has talent.
Maricek with the left-handed hook.
Nassau with that rebound. Good looking guy.
That's his fifth board of the game. Lee for three. Young with the offensive rebound.
That's the way to reverse. You got to reverse the ball. Swing it side to side. Great defenses down when you make that extra pass.
Here's Sauer.
Especially if you go to the other side of the floor.
Young still can't finish, but Collins does with the flash.
They really do a great job as Collins comes off the offside of attacking the glass from the weak side.
That was Jason Collins. Pardon me, Jaron Collins. It's all Collins to me, Dick. They are identical twins, born 8 minutes apart.
Jaron's more of an inside player. Jason has a little more finesse to his game.
Francis with a great jab step. And the rebound to Young.
See, now they got numbers the other way. You gotta back it out. Gotta back it up.
Reams doesn't hear you. And he misfires. Collins.
Forcing the action. Really playing out of control. And that's what they want you to do. Gotta back it out. They excel when they back it out. There's a diagonal pass. Mr. Francis has been a star of stars. Remember the name. Look at the height. Look at the elevation. Wow, look at the elevation, Mr. Francis. Now, here, watch the weak side now. Here comes the help side, and there is Mr. Collins with the jam. The lead is three for Maryland. The Kesey double team. You don't want to spin against that double team. They bring the help down from the perimeter. And Joe Bikini helping out that time on the interior. Mike Montgomery believes in his bench. He believes in the people he brings in, Joe Bikini and the Collins, and they got to produce. Joe Bikini played extensively in the first half. Mosley getting set to come in now for the Cardinal. But look at this pressure on the perimeter by Stokes. Akizi on the grab. You know, you think about the long term rather than the short term, and that's why he's trying to develop players for the most important part of their season, is certainly the Pac-10.
You know, Dick, not many teams so far in Maryland's eight games have forced the Terps to play half-court defense, but the scary thing is they're a good half-court defensive team.
Oh, they're just a good basketball team. There's no question about it. They are a good basketball team, an outstanding basketball team. And I still think Stanford's a very good basketball team. They may not be a super team because they don't possess the great quickness, but they can beat a lot of people with their execution.
Right now, though, just shooting 36% from the field. Collins from the foul line.
I mean, that's good execution. You got to knock that free throw down.
Whose ball? It'll stay with Stanford. Our Payne Weber Scholar Athlete of the Game, Mark Madsen, an economics and Spanish major. Pretty healthy GPA of 3.13.
I'll tell you what, after he was the star of one of the NIT games when they beat St. John's, about 11 o'clock at night, Howard Garfinkel, a five-star fame, myself, and some scouts, was sitting in a restaurant. Who's back in the corner all by himself with a computer out doing a term paper is Mark Madsen. He was doing an economics term paper right after the game.
Sauer hits the three-point shot to tie the game at 45.
I tell you, that may be sour, but that is sweet in the mind of Mr. Montgomery. That's a big three. They're tied up. They're not going away. You don't go to the Final Four and have quit in you, baby. They're going to get some touches for Morris as well. He's not touching the ball enough in their game.
Dixon fouled by Mosley that time. A couple of subs coming in for the Terps. Profit along with Francis.
Stanford foul for number 21, David Mosley. That's his second
personal. Well, we have played about 25 minutes, and we are knotted at 45.
So, what'll it take for you to buy this car today?
You're buying this SUV today or not?
I want you to drive out.
I want you to walk out of here with
just for you. I got
to tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to talk to my boss.
My supervisor.
Hey, we're going to have a deal, right?
Log on to AutoVitel.com. Arm yourself with dealer invoice and retail list prices. Choose any make, any model. No hassles, no haggling, low prices. AutoVitel.com. We're changing the way America buys cars.
When we drafted Tim Duncan, I invited him to my home to get ready for the season.
He was learning so much.
That doesn't count, you were out.
The roses are out, Timmy, not the daisies.
So one day, you brought this into my home?
It's not something I'm proud of.
I calmly explained how Edge Pro Gel protects better than foam because it has eight rich lubricants.
David, sure know how to make a guy feel comfortable.
More lemonade, Tim?
Edge Pro Gel. Save your skin.
The roses, Tim, are out of bounds.
Yo, with the gnomes. The gnomes can be out of bounds.
No.
Latest in a long history of exceptional cars from Audi, the Audi A6.
Here in Alabama, we have the Robert Trent Jones Golf Trail. Stretching 340 miles, it is one of the most comprehensive collections of public courses available anywhere, which makes Alabama quite possibly one of the best spots for golf that you can find. And even if you don't like golf, Alabama's also a great place to work on your swing. Call for more information.
John Daly and Laura Davies, golf's longest hitters, combine forces in the JCPenney Classic. Today at 4 Eastern on ABC.
Tied at 45 with 11:29 to play in the second half. And Payne Weber believes that the best investment is an investment in education. Today, saluting Mark Madsen as a scholar athlete of the game and congratulate him on his own investment in the future. Payne Weber recognizes that commitment to education with a $1,000 donation to Stanford University for ongoing research. Payne Weber, you can't lose with an investment in the future. The guy's so smart, we had to tell him twice, huh?
Yeah, we got to tell him twice. I'll tell you one thing. He combines great academics as well as athletics. I had two quality guys yesterday at the game at Duke. I wish all young kids would follow their example. Alex Rodriguez and Grant Hill. Two quality pros who have not become part of that scenario where they really are problems off the field or off the court.
Inside, Marisic rejected. Mosley with the ball for Stanford and the Cardinal with an opportunity to take the lead. And they got now a new backcourt with Giovicini back there along with Mr. Mosley. Lee getting a valuable rest right now. Collins going backdoor, and he's fouled by Stokes. A nice play that time by Stanford.
Well, Stanford got back again in this game from being down 11. They had a deficit of 11, and they got back because they really went back to executing on the offensive end and neutralized Maryland from getting up and down into transition.
Stanford running what they call quick.
Well, I'll tell you one thing, they're used to playing high caliber competition, losing in overtime in a Final Four to a team like Kentucky, beating Rhode Island to get to the situation where they got a chance to go to the Final Four.
Looking to build on that, but they won't do it that way. Collins losing his concentration and losing the ball.
Mike Montgomery said he was so proud to walk through San Antonio to River Wharf and see all those Stanford Cardinals shirts. He said that's what they've been working for. And they're sold out all their games at Maples Pavilion. You can't get a ticket.
Right now, thrust into the national spotlight. They've come back from an 11-point deficit to tie the game. Morris has it batted away inside.
Well, you know, he's only taken six shots and made four. Profit is 0 for 4. I mean, Profit was the MVP of that Puerto Rico shootout up there where they won that tournament, beating UCLA and blowing away Pittsburgh.
Caught the runner, no good. Collins with the rebound.
It's getting interesting right now. I'll tell you one thing, the crowd is getting a little bit out of it as well. They got the crowd quiet right now, Stanford.
A deafening type of silence if you're a Maryland fan.
You play under control. Whenever you play a high-paced team, a high-octane team who wants to play at the Daytona 500 raceway pace, you got to slow it down.
For those of you that have just joined us, it's number 2 Maryland against number 5 Sterling. And coming up next is the Totitos Bowl Championship Series Selection Show. That's next on ABC. Tennessee undefeated. Who will their opponent be in the Tostitos Fiesta Bowl? Will it be Ohio State, Florida State? We'll find out next.
Oh,
Francis. And which way are they calling this?
They call it a charge. Defensive player got there, got position. Great job by Collins to be able to step in and take that charge. He rotated over. It's one of those tough calls.
We had a very good look. We're right in front of us. I wouldn't want to have to make that call.
I thought it was definitely a charge. I thought he got to the spot. Mr. Mosley says hello to us.
Meanwhile, that's the second personal foul on Francis. Stanford with a chance to take the lead and break the tie at 45. Lee back in the ballgame.
The high low.
It's Collins to Collins. They run the high low. And a nice block from behind by Marnison.
Marnison is one of those great role players. Comes off the bench, gives you size. You shoot the jumper, gives you that big screening ability. So he's trying to set a screen for his buddy. Come on, Stevens, I'll set a screen for you. He's got pretty good handle to his game as well, Francis. He's the bomb. There's no doubt about it. He's the bomb.
They look for that lob again. And Francis couldn't get it.
He's trying to post now inside.
Dixon to the hole. Rejected by Collins. Boy, those two twins get it done inside.
Yeah, they're really playing very well together. And they really work well together. They did over at Harvard Westlake High School in the LA area. Almost went to UCLA. But inside, he wanted the ball. He had great position.
Working hard. Mosley comes off the screen for three.
Nothing but butter on that one.
I'll tell you one thing. He could shoot the three. You're right about butter. Smooth as can be. I'll tell you this, Mark. He shot 43% from the trifecta last year.
I think that's their first lead since 24-22.
He and the Mendez kid is not playing today. Both were 47% and 43% from the three.
Terrence Morris, meanwhile, has cooled off a little bit. Out of bounds, it'll be Maryland ball. Akizi coming in for Martisic.
And the reason they cooled off, it's again becoming a half-court game. I mean, they excel in transition. Absolutely excel. They're probably the best team in America using the 94 feet.
Akizi in the paint. Wheeling inside.
What an unbelievable play on the inside. Look at Gary Williams. He's frustrated because Tal Hillary calls it a charge. Oh, no. He signaled the charge, and that's what absolutely had Williams go bananas. He signaled the charge, but then he saw the other official call it. They're going to call it that quick. Blaine Taylor flashing quick.
Well, I'd be running quick every time down the floor.
That's quick. If that's quick, let him do it.
Akizi with a chance to equalize now for Maryland at the foul line. He has made his last 17 free throws. He was 9-for-9 in their previous game. He has the last 15 points. He has hit his last 15 free throws over the last two games.
Yeah, it was 9-for-9. The last game, 6-for-6 here. And that's a big plus when your big guy is going to go to the line can convert. He looks great at that line. Great release. The best in America, though, is Trajan Langdon. He is just automatic, that dude. And that's such a plus late in the game to put the ball in his hand.
Here comes the pressure, full court.
Pressure has not bothered him here in the second half. He's trying to get into a trapping area. They're very quick with Dixon out there. Also with Crawford.
And Madsen falls and travels.
We're going to watch the ball go inside when we see Akizi. He catches the ball to the inside. He's going to whirl to the goal. Takes it up strong.
Inside again to Akizi. A lot of contact, and he's called for the travel. Akizi, who played for Nigeria this summer in the World Championships, gaining a lot of experience. Called for the travel that time. Maryland still in their 55 defense. That's full court pressure.
Yeah, they want to always stay in that 55. They're looking to always take you to trapping areas. Slide back inside. I would go right now to Mad Dog. They have not proved they can handle him down in the box. I would go inside to him.
They come to this side of the floor, and now Mosley comes off the baseline screen. Hit his last one.
I'll tell you what, two
from three-point land.
He's heating it up, baby. And if they make that trifecta, they become dynamite.
Mosley gives Stanford a three-point lead.
They're jumping with joy right now down at Palo Alto.
Might have been that quick play they ran again. Inside, Prophet can't hang on. This has not been LaRon Prophet's afternoon. Miller getting set to come into the game, as is Terrell Stokes. The Stanford Cardinal threatening to spoil Maryland's perfect 8-0 season. We'll return after these messages in a word from our ABC station.
It's time for the Quaker Oats fans of the game.
Zero to your heart in 1 second flat. The Audi A6.
The more you do something, the better you get. State Farm's been settling car insurance claims for over 75 years, millions of them. We've come up with a system that works so well that more drivers trust State Farm than all those cut-rate insurance companies put together. You're buying into that promise that we're going to be there to take care of you when the claim happens. Every day, State Farm handles over 30,000 claims. It's a practice makes perfect thing. That's the reason the competition doesn't stand a chance.
And like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
When your car needs service, the choices, just like today's cars, can be complicated.
Let Maneki put all the pieces together. Count on Meineke for brake systems, shocks, struts, and of course, mufflers. Because they're specialists, you always pay that great, low Meineke price.
At Meineke, you won't pay a lot, but you'll get a lot.
I guarantee it.
Hey, bubblegum blowers. Know how you love the classic flavor of extra classic bubblegum? Now the flavor lasts longer than ever. So you can enjoy blowing lots of extra bubbles. How many extra?
25 extra.
31 extra.
The flavor and the bubbles go on and on.
15 extra.
33 extra.
So remember, try extra classic bubblegum. Why? Now the flavor you love lasts longer than ever.
Hey, Germantown, News 7 is on your side.
Watching Payne Weber College basketball on ABC Sports.
We are in the nation's capital, and welcome back to Payne Weber College basketball. Stanford leading by three, and Dick, you ran across something in our media guide.
Oh, look at us right here. That's our producer, Kim Belton, baby. 1,650 points. Look at those shorts. He's a muscle man. They could use him on the inside. He would have been a big-time NBA player, but hurt his knee. He was drafted second round by Phoenix. Kimberly Belton.
Giving us some great direction and production in the truck today.
Well, proving to you young people out there there's more in life than just basketball. He injured his knee, and he utilized that Stanford degree to have a great career now in the world of television.
At least one of us got into a real school, huh?
Well, he coaches me every play in the truck. I mean, every play. You got to go talk about this, talk about that, talk about this. But he knows his basketball.
7.5 minutes to play, and the Cardinal lead by three. Look at the little half-court pressure by Maryland.
Got to get a little nervous right now if you're a Maryland fan because the traps.
Mosley. Boy. Stanford looking like they're falling off the cliff, and they do.
See, got out of control right there. The traps weren't bothering them, but they got out of control. A little high step in time.
Dick, Maryland is just 3 of 16 from the field in the second half.
I have one question.
What's that?
Where has been Mr. Prophet? Where has been the MVP in a Puerto Rico shootout?
An unprofitable game so far for him. Stokes back in the ball game for the Terps.
He's such a versatile player, a multi-dimensional.
Miller coming off the screen. They go inside to Akizi. And a foul called against the Cardinal.
I'll tell you, Akizi has really developed a lot of footwork inside. He's got game down there in that post. His idol is Hakeem Olajuwon. Not a used to, got a chance to meet him. We're going to watch the steal. They do a great job of always deflecting from the rear. See, that was created by Francis with the rear deflection. Jimmy Valvano, the late Jimmy V, used to teach that really well.
And Akizi, his footwork is tremendous.
Oh, watch his agility inside. Now look at the big fella posting up inside. He and Elton Brand are going to really hook up big time in that showdown. What a matchup that's going to be. I love the diaper dandy at Duke, Corey McGetty.
Mosley travels, so they turn it over again against the half-court trap.
And it's created by Francis again. He created the steal on one end, created the turnover. Mike Montgomery worked for that sideline. Who said coach is easy, baby? They earned those mega dollars.
6.5 minutes to play, and Stanford leads by three. Maryland undefeated coming in at 8-0.
Trying to take advantage of Morris down inside with his quick miss.
Stokes for three.
That's a big time three by Stokes. Not known for knocking down a lot of big shots. He had 15 assists, a career high in the game earlier this year.
Doesn't shoot a lot. Tied at 51.
Mosley hit two big threes earlier in this game. Also hit some big ones last year against Purdue in the NCAA tournament and then to beat Rhode Island to go to the Elite Eight.
Mosley for three, finally misses, but a great rebound by Seton that time, but a foul called on Mad Dog.
Yeah, Mad Dog called for the push. They forgot about Mad Dog, haven't given him enough touches on the inside.
Got a lot of time on a shot clock to get to him. Maryland, cold shooting in this half.
Yeah, 4-17 can get you in deep trouble against anyone. Gary Williams, great career, started with Tom Davis, who gave him an opportunity at Lafayette. Worked with Tom at Maryland when he was a grad assistant. Hate to see Tom leaving the coaching profession, but Then he took him with him to Lafayette. Then he went to Boston College with him. Then he became a head coach at American University, Boston College, Ohio State, and now back at his alma mater. Success everywhere he's been.
Dick, at practice yesterday, LaRon Prophet and his teammates, they had an intense practice. There were bodies all over the court. I mean, they were laying the lumber on each other.
He keeps looking up on the clock, LaRon, saying, wow, I got to get some more minutes out here. And Coach Williams is saying, hey, I'll give you minutes, but you got to produce, baby. You don't produce, you become an assistant coach. You sit next to me. And LaRon's too talented sitting there.
Maryland, a perfect 13 of 13 from the line. Like I said, a perfect, almost perfect.
Well, the 13, put the jinx on them. Look at Stokes trying to fire up the club. They know they're in for a real bailout special. This is going down to the wire. The stomach is starting to get a little nervous.
Lee inside.
Make the extra pass. He had wings.
Madsen up strong. Rejected. Francis. Uh-oh.
He's so explosive out of the open court. Steve Francis, the new star down in Maryland.
His 20th point of the ball game, and Maryland leads by three.
The MCI is rocking. See, his excitement and his energy just gets this crowd energized. Abita Akizi's really taking on the challenge of playing Mad Dog head-to-head now.
Francis with another
score. Uh-oh. He's a super. He's the 3S man. Super Cinderella Sensesto. He's the 3-0 man. He's magical. He's marvelous. He's magnificent. It's so beautiful, Mark, when you have a player that can give you such an unbelievable lift. And he is that kind of player. He's a momentum builder. There he is rotating over with the steal. And then he knows how to finalize by sliding and gliding and laying on the glass. So many times players get reputations coming out of high school or the junior college ranks, and there's no way they can live up to them. This guy has lived up to everything that I've heard about him.
Had a great chat with him yesterday at practice. Said, you know, Coach Williams isn't screaming and shouting as much as he did a year ago. I said, that's because you're here now.
Exactly. Look at us right now. Fast break opportunities. It's unbelievable. 19-2. Kind of expected, though, because the styles of play and personnel.
Stanford has got to find some calm.
This is a big, big possession in this game. This is one of the major possessions. They're going to stop this momentum right now. Lee's got to step up right here.
12 on the shot clock. Montgomery trying to get a handle on his offensive unit. And there's a foul before the shot.
Good job executing here. Took some time off the clock, slowed down the pace a little bit. Look at two. Lane Taylor, he came out of Montana. He didn't know he was going to flash all those numbers. He's going to get a lot of 18, a lot of airtime. Everywhere they play, people are going to be flashing that sideline. What they're doing here for the people that are watching, they are calling off sets. They're a very structured team. They run specific sets, and execution is very vital to them for success.
Wayne, just 2 of 5 on the season from the line. Missing a crucial one there, Maryland ball. Montgomery's taken his team to 6 NCAAs.
Last 4 years. Sweet 16 2 years ago, last year to the Final Four. A magical place that all college coaches want to ultimately in.
He says he's looking at the big picture, not looking at this game as a make or break. And an offensive foul called against Akizi.
Tony Nunez with the call down in the post. Akizi has really improved his game down in that low block. He's got 4 fouls, and that could be big. But they have a player to go to in Martisic.
You know, Dick, you wonder how tired Stanford might be. This is their second trip that they've made cross-country this year. That's a lot of mileage.
Yeah, but you know, they had a week to rest. They really did, and kids are resilient. Kids can really bounce back, but they did have that week where they were able to rest and get ready for this game.
They trail by 5 with 3:50 to play.
So now go down to Madsen against the inexperience of Martisic.
Williams had it knocked away by... Boy, Steve Francis has taken 11 other Maryland players, putting them on his broad shoulders, and trying to take them to the promised land right now.
He's also a cheerleader. He's raising the roof, baby. He's raising the roof.
Defense, he's got that too. We'll be right back.
Ladies and gentlemen, please turn to page 3 of your...
It is more than a trial by fire. It is a rite of passage. And if you can master your fear, outsmart your enemy, and never yield, even to yourself, you will be changed forever. The few, the proud, the Marines.
So, what'll it take for you to buy this car today?
You're buying this SUV today or not?
I want you to drive out.
I want you to walk out of here with...
Just for you, I gotta
tell you what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna talk to my boss.
My supervisor.
Hey, we're gonna have a deal, right?
Log on to AutoBuyTel.com. Arm yourself with dealer invoice and retail list prices. Choose any make, any model. No hassles, no haggling, low prices. AutoBuyTel.com. We're changing the way America buys cars.
Latest in a long history of exceptional cars from Audi, the Audi A6.
Dennis told me about this new gum.
It's in the toothpaste aisle.
New Arm & Hammer Dental Care Gum with Baking Soda reduces unsightly plaque up to 25% for whiter teeth and a healthy, fresher, cleaner mouth.
It was in the,
toothpaste aisle.
Oh, yeah.
Arm & Hammer Dental Care Gum.
Toothpaste aisle.
Guess what 62-year-old woman Drew has the hots for?
You haven't dazzled me, but you really wore me down.
The Partridge Family of Shirley Jones on an all-new Drew Carey. See you ABC Wednesday.
Get our bags. Welcome back to the MCI Center. Maryland leading by 5.
I wanted Obina, baby. Obina is awesome, baby.
And don't forget, coming up today, it's the JCPenney Classic. John Daly and Laura Davies among the golfers showcased in this event. 4 p.m. Eastern Time, 1 o'clock Pacific, right here on ABC.
You talk about a player that's really taken over to PT Pier, Francis. He's really changed the complexion of this game. You know, Madsen has not touched the ball in the last 12 minutes after starting so hot.
And Weems hits the three-pointer.
That's the three they need. They got to get Weems to give them the perimeter game he's capable of. They need scoring out of that second slot. He and Lee do a great job on the defensive end.
Weems.
Last year, they were co-defensive players of the year on the team.
Francis posted up for a split second, and a hold called against the Cardinal inside. Maryland will shoot.
A real positive for Gary Weems this year is the ability of Maryland to convert at the free throw line.
And coming into this game, they were shooting in the mid-60s, but over the last two games, they have made a string of consecutive free throws.
So great, an event like this brings so much money to charities, for children, and that's phenomenal. They said they're going to raise over $600,000 net for the children's charity, and that's just fantastic.
Wonderful cause. Morris with 11 points in the game.
He's a star. There's no question he's got star ability. He's been playing really well this year. Oh, comes back with, that's a tough loss right there for Stanford, giving up that missed free throw.
Costing them a possession. Francis. Artisette's coming up a baseline screen. Morris wheeling.
So quick on the interior.
And Collins is fouled by Francis.
See, that's not a smart play right there. Steve's got to know that. That's his fourth. That's not a smart play. If this baby goes to OT, they need him on the floor.
Dick, what do you do with four fouls this late? Do you leave him in or not? First, though, let me tell you, folks, Wednesday night after Drew Carey, the summer's biggest hit is back with all new episodes. You won't believe it's all spontaneous. Whose line is it anyway? Wednesday, 9:30, 8:30 Central on ABC.
Well, you know, you talk about late in the game like this, I would leave him on the floor. I also, he's going to bring in Obino Ekezi down the stretch as well.
Ron Proffitt getting set to come in with him.
Well, Proffitt's a guy that can make things happen late in the game, and he has that ability. He's got a world of experience. He's super quick.
Collins, a 63% free throw shooter. It's nothing but net on that one.
Nice stroke right there.
Stanford 4 of 7 from the line. And Francis, as we mentioned, with four personals.
Jason with that nice touch at the line. Been a real good college basketball game. Great environment.
Sauer battling, but couldn't get the tip to go. Francis with the rebound.
See, now you got to play under control. You got to understand time. You got to understand score. You got to understand matchups. As Gary gets a 20-second timeout. It is framework right now. We're to the no longer the exempt games. We're going to be using 5 30-second timeouts, which I like that rule. I don't like the 45-second rule. I like the 35-second clock, and I like the idea of the five. I wish they'd use the 5 30-second clock. As you see here, the top teams in America. North Carolina got beat last night at number 3. Duke won big. Kansas had a nice win. Cincinnati, really impressive. They really are impressive.
And Dick Temple with a close loss yesterday against Indiana in Bloomington.
Well, they've lost a lot of close games lately.
They've against
been
really, Penn?
Oh, they've been getting beat at the buzzer. They've got a good basketball team. Had a tough break, though. They lost a key kid by the name of Greer. Hey, you know who's next? They better hope they get this W, baby.
This one's certainly not done.
You know, the concept they're using now is the regular timeouts, which are 2 for a TV game, regular timeouts, and 3 20-second timeouts.
Let's see what they run out of this timeout. 20 seconds on the shot clock, 2:40 in the game. Morris.
Execution so important in a 5-on-5 situation. Spacing becomes important.
9 on the shot clock. Stokes in traffic. The play really seemed to blow up.
Yeah, really went nowhere right there. He tried to get into a seam to create penetration and dump it off to the big guy on the inside.
Just 4 on the shot clock. They've got to be aware of that.
Clock starts as soon as he touches it.
Proffitt, is it time? No. An agonizing afternoon for Proffitt.
You know, A.J. Guyton had a tough time yesterday. It was 1-for-9, and then all of a sudden knocked the big 3 to beat Temple at the buzzer. I thought maybe that was going to happen with Proffitt.
Sauer working hard to get open inside, posting up.
They have Mad Dog again inside, and he's got Ekezi with 4. You got to dump the ball into him. You got to dump it into Mad Dog. He's got to take advantage of Ekezi's 4 fouls. Got to know that. Got to know time. You got to know.
10 on the shot clock.
Oh!
The bank's open.
I tell you, the bank is open, no question. But that could bring a smile to a lot of Stanford fans. That could mean that something good's going to happen.
Tied at 57 with 1:41 to play in the second half.
Stanford certainly has made it the kind of game they wanted it to be. It was not a racehorse game up and down the floor, only in spurts.
Maryland forced to play half court right here, right now.
When they had that going up and down, they got up to an 11-point lead in the first half.
Francis fouled inside. They're going to call Weems on the hold.
They call Weems with the hold. Collins was calling jump ball. So give it to us. Defense gets it in that situation.
And Dick, again, they went deep into the shot clock. There were less than 10 seconds to go on.
Well, one great thing is Weems wants the walk. Weems right now is certainly playing on the defensive end, but Gary Williams, his kid Francis, really wants the ball late in the game. He's 5 for 5 on a free throw line. He's perfect so far.
And he will rub his right arm before he shoots as a tribute to his late mother, who meant so much to him. Before every foul shot, he rubs his right arm. He has a tattoo and a cross on it. And on that cross is her name, Brenda.
His mom passed away when he was a senior in high school. 7 for 7, like automatic on the lines.
Dixon coming into the game.
He gives them quickness right now. They got a quick lineup.
And they keep the pressure on, too.
The experience of Stanford has kept them in this game. Remember, this team's been through these kind of matchups.
Arthur Lee, Dick, picked it up at the worst possible place on the court.
And we got that 20-second timeout. You're exactly right. You don't want to go there. That's a dead-end spot.
A 20-second timeout called.
I mean, these are good matchups. You know, you got so many cupcake battles going on, bargain basement goodies for Christmas. But these things are really special because you really find out about your club. You get an exact analysis as to your strengths, your weaknesses, and what you're about.
And Maryland, as well as Stanford, with a tough stretch of games coming up. Maryland has Kentucky coming up in a couple of weeks.
Well, we're doing that Kentucky game. Actually, it's next Saturday. Brad Nessler and I will be down in Lexington, Kentucky, and that'll be interesting down there. Tough place to play. Rupp Arena is certainly one of the great environments in college basketball.
Kentucky with a big win at home yesterday against the University of Miami and Leonard Hamilton, homecoming for him.
Yeah, you know, Hamilton came back, and they were down early in that game, Kentucky. But here we go, down the stretch.
Two-point game.
I still would make sure they isolate and go a two-man game if I were there, and I would go to Mr. Mad Dog Madsen. Akizi's got 4,000. People have a tendency when they play with four to get a little passive. I'd bring the ball into the big guy. I'd dump it into him. I'd dump it on. I should have dumped it. They missed him.
Here's Lee on the spin, and he traveled.
Oh, they had the opportunity, had the angle. You could see that was the strategy of Mike Montgomery. They brought it over to the help side, had a two-man game. He was sitting in the box inside against Akizi with four and never touched the ball.
Yeah, Dick, when a guy works so hard in the post to get open, you have to
look
give it to him.
Look at this. You got to give him the ball. Are you kidding me? He's got to get the ball. Akizi's got four fouls. He's got him sitting on his back. You got to bring the Mad Dog to rock. Recognition. You got to read when to get the ball in. That's one of the little problems Duke has. They don't read at the right time to get the ball into Elton Brand.
Part of not being able to get it in, though, the perimeter pressure by Maryland, though, don't you think?
Yeah, they do a great job pressuring the basketball. But in that sequence there, look at Mike Montgomery talking to Tommy Nunes, and you know he's not saying, hey, where do you like to go to eat here in Washington, D.C.?
Let's go, Maryland!
This guy keeps splashing. ACC equals the best conference. No doubt about it. You talk about great basketball year in and year out, and great environments with unbelievable excitement.
It's the ACC has ACC against the Pac-10 right here. Under a minute to play, 42 seconds. Two-point game, Stanford down.
They're going to try to spread the court right now. Remember, Maryland's exceptionally good on a free throw line this season.
And Maryland burns one of its timeouts. Contemplate the next 35.2 seconds.
Well, you know, with the shot clock the way it is right now, you know that Stanford's going to get the ball back, but it's important for them to come up with a stop here. They can't allow Maryland to put points on a board in this possession, whether it be from the free throw line or from a score on a field goal attempt.
Maryland can put a very good ball handling team out there because they're so versatile.
This would be a great win for Maryland from the standpoint that they've been really tested, that they have not been able to go up and down, and yet still can get the W. That would be a great win.
This is the non-class play of the day.
Yeah, see, he's got to get the ball. Look at that position. Are you serious? He's got great offensive position inside. The guy checking him's got four fouls, and he does not touch the ball.
The Audi play of the game. That was it, the non-pass to Madsen.
Man-to-man defense, good hedge right here.
Francis. Whose ball is it? It's Maryland ball.
Maryland comes up with the ball. They're bumping chest now. Morris and Abina Akizi. They've been in a war here today. These kids from Stanford have really battled. He wants to carry. He's a Tommen baby. That's the point of emphasis this year.
Shot clock is off now, and Profit is fouled. Maybe a good guy to foul. LaRon Profit has not had a good time shooting the ball today.
Well, and also psychologically, he might be struggling a little bit mentally off his poor performance, so you're exactly right. Dr. Jones with the call right there, a doctor of hoopology. When are we going to have a little NBA showtime on ESPN?
I'm ready to go whenever they are. Profit 0 for 5 from the field. And this is his first free throw attempt of the afternoon. That's why you have seniors, Dick.
Yeah, come up big right in that possession. This the big one, though, coming up next after the timeout.
That one makes it a four-point game if he sinks the next free throw. What? Gary Williams will contemplate his next move in this chess match when we come back.
They think the market's going to go up 20% next year.
What are
they
doing? Tickets, folks. I'm
out. I keep reading about tax-efficient investing. Should I be doing that?
Everybody else seems to.
Let's see. Rates are falling, inflation's low, more stocks or more bonds.
Hey. Oh, man.
This investment strategy is for you. Great. Just for me and 5 million other people.
Thank you, Payne Webber.
Zero to your heart in 1 second flat. The Audi A6.
Where'd it go? The year's almost over. Isn't this the year things were going to be different? You were going to pay off all those credit cards, get out of debt, stop worrying so much? Well, there's still time. Call the money store. Get a home loan. Get back on track. You'll have a check in your hands before the year is over. Before the year is over.
The Money Store. 1-800-LOAN-YES.
My dentist told me about this new gum.
It's in the toothpaste aisle.
New Arm & Hammer Dental Care Gum with Baking Soda reduces unsightly plaque up to 25% for whiter teeth and a healthy, fresher, cleaner mouth.
It was in the,
toothpaste aisle.
Oh, yeah.
Arm & Hammer Dental Care Gum.
Toothpaste aisle.
At Pep Boys, get 4 of our 35,000-mile tires at a low $99. Or double your mileage with 4 70,000-mile, all-season steel-belted tires, just $169.
Pep Boys.
Cars like us.
People love us.
Payne Webber College Basketball on ABC and Raycom Sports brought to you by Payne Webber. Thank you, Payne Webber, for the advice. Audi and the dashing and daringly beautiful A6. Can one car change the way you look at all cars? The U.S. Army, be a part of the toughest, smartest army in the world. And by State Farm Insurance, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Well, our Audi play of the game, their inability, Stanford's, to get it into Madsen may end up costing them, Dick.
I'll tell you right now, you look at Profit, he's shooting 56% for the year on the free throw line. This is the big one. This gives you two possessions, and he converts here.
And he misses the second.
Got a shot right now.
Stanford down by just 16 seconds to go.
See, I wouldn't let him look at the three.
Oh, and Sauer couldn't control. He was looking at the basket.
You know what's really helped Maryland here? Big time. They shot 40% from the field, but 90% from the free throw.
And they'll get an easy.
It's all over. It's academic. And Maryland gets the tough W today against a very good Stanford team. They're going to grow and be a better team as he nails the three. Just a quick timeout.
It's down to just 2 points.
He nails that three big time. But think about this. Stanford played St. John's, came back and won that game after being down 10, lost a heartbreaker tough one in North Carolina, and right here, playing Maryland right to the wire. The bottom line is, these games were not in Palo Alto, where they're going to be unbelievable. In fact, their radio voice does a great job. Bob Murphy told me every game sold out, and this is a real good test. This is going to help this team grow, and they get Mendez back and McDonald. So anybody that's writing them off is making a major mistake. But a big-time win, if they hold this in the last 5 seconds, Maryland, it's a big-time win that they were able to win under a different kind of style that they really dominate with and that they had to play a lot of half-court.
Mike Montgomery taking a look at that last three-pointer by Arthur Lee.
Quickly gets the T.O.
Meanwhile, a look of slight anguish from Gary Williams.
Look at him, look at him. Oh, is he furious.
Don't forget, coming up next, it's the Totitos BCS Selection Show. We'll let you know who's playing against Tennessee in the Totitos Fiesta Bowl coming up in the desert.
Well, Mark, right now the strategy is very simple. You try to make the steal on the inbounds of the basketball, you face guard, you front, you put pressure on the ball. If you don't make that steal, you got to put them on the line and hope they come up empty on the line and then have enough time to wield some magic. Magic that's happened for them. I mean, who could ever forget being down 6 with 59 seconds and King Arthur Lee made some unbelievable plays in Madsen in the win over Rhode Island. Right in the lane, he deflected one. Madsen got it and scored. And a controversial call, and that Jimmy Herrick was furious, thought there was a foul. But here comes the pressure.
They got the home run ball last time down court to Profit.
Yeah, they threw the Sammy Sosa special and a Mark McGwire special. You can use that pass.
Nice play.
Oh, you got a foul right away. You got a foul right away.
It's going to run out.
Oh, it's all over. Easy. Hello. Hello.
This one is cooked, glazed, and ready to be sliced.
It's all over, baby. Another win for the Maryland Terrapins. They're going to be tough to beat. In fact, I look at their next really tough game, obviously, is Kentucky on the road. That's going to be a tough one for them.
Coming up next Saturday, Maryland improves to 9-0 with a slim and tenuous two-point win over Stanford.
I still would have liked to see what would have happened if the ball went inside to Madsen. But you got a foul here, but they did a great job executing Maryland. Look how they spread. Look how they spread the court. They throw the ball along the baseline, and then the diagonal pass, and that was it. It was all over there. Very tough to really foul in that situation.
And Steve Francis put in a good day's work for the University of Maryland. And we're going to have both Steve Francis and Coach Gary Williams in just a few moments. The final score once again from the MCI Center, Maryland by a deuce. But first, back to Robin Roberts in New York.
All right, Mark, thank you very much. A wild finish there at the MCI Center. We'll get back there for reaction. Plus, we'll have scores coming up on the post-game report. So stay with us, everyone. We're coming back.
At GEICO, we settle claims quickly so you can get your car back, because no one likes to bum a ride to work. GEICO, a 15-minute call could save you 15% or more on car insurance. Paying too much for car insurance isn't any smarter. GEICO, a 15-minute call could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Latest in a long history of exceptional cars from Audi, the Audi A6.
Where'd it go? The year's almost over. Isn't this the year things were going to be different? You were going to pay off all those credit cards, get out of debt, stop worrying so much? Well, there's still time. Call the money store. Get a home loan. Get back on track. You'll have a check in your hands before the year is over. Before the year is over.
The Money Store. 1-800-LOAN-YES.
We'll return to the MCI Center in just a moment, where Maryland has just defeated Stanford 62-60, so the Terps remain undefeated, but just barely. Let's bring up to speed another college hoop scores from around the country. Western Michigan and Michigan getting it on at this hour. In the second half, it is Western Michigan leading the Wolverines 43-36. Elsewhere, Auburn and Florida State very early on, with the Seminoles leading by three. And one game is complete. St. Peter's with its first win of the year, defeating Canisius 60-50. Ricky Bellinger, 19 points and 6 rebounds for the Peacocks. To the NFL. Steve Young with a pair of touchdown passes as the Niners lead Carolina 28-14. Kerry Collins for the Saints has a pair of touchdown passes. They lead the Cowboys, surprisingly, 22-3 in the third. And the Jaguars up on Detroit, 24-6. Also, Doug Flutie is helping Buffalo lead Cincinnati at this point. New England with a 7-point lead over the Pittsburgh Steelers. And the Jets trailing Seattle right now. Joey Galloway with a pair of touchdown receptions for Seattle. Atlanta has come back. They're now leading the Colts. Chris Chandler, two touchdown passes and also ran one in himself. And San Diego and Washington tied at 17-all in the third quarter. So again, we're going to get you out to the MCI Center to see how Maryland barely stayed undefeated, beating Stanford. That and much more when we come back here in the postgame report.
Introducing the Nissan Frontier V6. With shift on the fly four-wheel drive and 200 foot-pounds of torque, it's the perfect truck for those really big jobs. The Nissan Frontier.
Here in Alabama, we have the Robert Trent Jones Golf Trail. Stretching 340 miles, it is one of the most comprehensive collections of public courses available anywhere, which makes Alabama quite possibly one of the best spots for golf that you can find. And even if you don't like golf, Alabama's also a great place to work on your swing. Call for more information.
Now it's time for the State Farm Women's Profile. Today we highlight two outstanding members of the Stanford Cardinal basketball team. At 6'6", Cardinal forward and center Carolyn Moos is the third tallest player in Stanford history. Cardinal fans are continually dazzled by her powerful inside moves. She leads the team in scoring and rebounding, averaging over 17 points and 7 boards a game. Only a sophomore, Moos will be a tall task for Stanford opponents for years to come. Next, we highlight Moos' backcourt teammate, Lindsay Yamasaki. This 6'1 guard was a consensus All-America selection out of Oregon City High School. One of the nation's top recruits in both basketball and volleyball, Yamasaki has quickly proven to be among the country's elite freshmen, scoring her first collegiate double-double against fifth-ranked Duke in only her fourth career start. This has been the State Farm Women's Profile.
John Saunders and Todd Blackledge standing by for the Tostitas BCS selection show to let you know who is going where in those vital bowls. But first, Maryland and Stanford, a game you just saw here on ABC. Very close throughout, especially in the early going as Gary Williams' team trying to stay undefeated. Mark Madsen grabs the rebound, the reverse layup, and Stanford had the early lead, but in the second half, Danny Miller, the alley-oop to Steve Francis. He's going to be a good one to watch. Maryland by five. Then Francis, oh, that's not easy. Stealing from Arthur Lee, goes the length of the floor. Maryland by five. But still, Stanford had a chance. Closing seconds, they need a three, but just off the hands of Peter Sauer. Just too hard from Arthur Lee. And Gary Williams' team holds on to win by a final of 62-60. Steve Francis, 24 points, a perfect 7-for-7 from the line. So what we want to hear from Steve Francis, so let's go back out to the MCI Center and Mark Jones. Mark?
Hey, Robin, we wish you could have been here because it's the type of game that you would have really enjoyed. Maryland by a deuce. And when Stanford looks back on their second loss of the season, they'll look back to this critical possession when they trailed by 2 points. Mark Madsen was working so very hard to get open inside. Akizi had 4 fouls on him, but Stanford was unable to get the ball inside to him. Right now, let's go to Dick Vitale with two of his new best friends.
Well, I'm here with the two stars. Guy Gary Williams certainly had a star on that sideline, and Steve Francis, who was absolutely sensational. Gary, there is no doubt about it that your club is excellent, especially in transition, but you were really tested today by this good Stanford team.
Dick, like you said, Stanford's a great team. We were very fortunate to win that game. We hit a couple big shots, but you can see Stanford's just starting to get it back to where they were, and they're going to be really tough the rest of the year.
I'll tell you one thing, Gary. This guy is the real deal. Steve, you've made some big plays today. I know you don't like that style. You want to go up and down the court. You don't like that half-court game.
A lot of people say, you know, we weren't good at our half-court offense, but today I think we've really executed our half-court offense, and we played real well today, Dick.
I'll tell you, you're absolutely sensational, and just keep listening to this guy because you're going to have an unbelievable year. Gary, this club right now, when you look at your club, how good is this basketball team?
Well, I think today was a big step because we played a great team that plays half-court basketball the way it should be played, and really, that's not our game. And they got us into their game, and we proved we could stay in there. We didn't look pretty all the time, but we really hung tough when we had to. And, you know, some of the young guys like Danny Miller and, of course, Steve, being new to the program, and Terrence Morris really played great for us.
Why are you making free throws? And this guy made him. Hey, number 23, is there a reason?
I like to wear 23. That's the same number I wore out of game last year, so I'm going to stick with it.
There's another guy that used to wear that number, played. He's not playing right now because they're on a little bit of a lockout situation. Mr. Jordan, any reason?
Not really. I mean, I like the way Michael Jordan plays, but, I mean, there's no significance behind it.
Well, I know one thing. This guy likes the way you play. I'll tell you, Gary, great, great W, and enjoy it. Go to the locker room. Stevie, big win. That's it right now from Gary Williams and from Steve Francis.